number two, Bob Timmer. A little tap on the number one lead car. And he's not going to be able to get it going. We get a yellow flag. Via the 7th car gets 2nd place, number 11 Ed Dando gets 3rd, and car number 16, Chris Brawley, finishes up in 4. The 27th car, John Petsko, 69, Dave Suber, and 45, Jim Blick, and 31, Terry Melke, 58, Jeff McCall. Car number 22. race for the Petco Mustang. John Petco second. Jim Click is third. And the 31, Terry Milky is fourth, trying to take away third place from Click. Car fourth, and Chris Oppenstreet fifth. Julianne running out in front.
down to take the white flag. We got one more lap to go. We're still in. And Chris Bowley's moving up on her. Julianne trying to stay out in front one more lap and take the checkered flag for the heat race win. And gonna take a checkered flag. Jack Seeley is turning tonight. Julianne Cass, she's her win the heat race. Julianne Seeley takes the checkered win in the heat on the figure eight track. Number 16, Chris Frawley, finishes second. Car number 11, Ed Gazzo, gets the third place finish. And the 90, Rich Ockletree, finishes in fourth place. Ego Challenge competition underway.
You want a drink?
1992 Eagle, this is Mike Stewart. His first lap at 23.01 on the first lap. Mike Stewart, the 92 Eagle. First, the second lap at 22.30. That's faster than two laps for Mike. Up next, Dean Stewart, a 1991 Mitsubishi. Dean Stewart in a 91 Mitsubishi on the clock. Ego Challenge competition, letting folks run their street legal automobile around the track against the clock, a couple of laps by themselves. First lap is at 26.33. Dean finishing his second lap at 25.73. Buster Hicks, a 1990 Toyota pickup. He did a 21.99 last time out. Tonight he's got a 21.58. He bettered that time on his first lap. Buster at the 91 Toyota. On the second lap for the number blue and an 85 Lotus. .84 on the first lap. Second time around, 21.84, the faster of the two. That's second time in a row. Kirk Arambulo. Here on this particular entry, but little Mazda, driven by Roger Miller. Late model Mazda hatchback. .55 on the first lap for Roger.
Give it to ice cream, America's favorite treat. Whoa, Kelly!
23.28. Faster the two laps for Roger Miller and the little Mazda. 23.28. Tom, are you selling those Thrillas from Vanilla's? Ice cream vendor extraordinaire.
That time I rolled off the rim.
Alright, here's a six-cylinder. 72 Datsun. This is Dan Yoshika in a 72 Datsun. Actually, it might be a 240, back in the 72 model. 240 was the first one they built. Tom, how you doing? Uh-oh. And gets it sideways, but saves it from going all the way around. Loses some time. 24.37 on the first lap for Dan Yoshika. Well, he takes it in after only one time around. And Yoshioka. Y-O-S-H-I-O-K-A. Yoshioka. Dan Yoshioka in the 72 Datsun. Faster of the two laps, 24.37. '87 Buick Grand National. This is Jim Jones, James Jones, in a '87 Buick Grand National six-cylinder. Lap at 24.77. I remember right, that turbo needs to have quite a few RPMs before it kicks in, and it doesn't look like it's getting enough of a kick to get the turbo fired up there coming off the turns. 24.71, the faster of the two laps for James Jones, and an 87 Buick Grand National six-cylinder turbo. Chris Carlson up next in an 86 Nissan Maxima. Chris Carlson. '86 Nissan Maxima, six-cylinder, big four-door sedan. Chris Carlson on his first lap. .63, first time around for Chris. Second lap at 23 seconds flat for Chris Carlson. 23 flat, a six-cylinder Nissan Maxima. On the clock, Ego Challenge Competition. You can do this in a couple of weeks. Bring your street legal car out to the racetrack around 3 o'clock or so and sign up. A couple of laps on the track by yourself against the clock. Compete in our Ego Challenge Competition. .24.06.
that first lap.
For Kenny Briggs, the faster of the two laps, the 93 Nissan Maxima. Are those color photos of Davey Allison and Richard Petty in our photo booth down next to the souvenir stand behind turn four? All right, up next. Dodson, this is Bill Vint Jr., Vint, V-I-N-T, Bill Vint Jr. in a 1980 280 CX. 25.20 on the... Got it. 23.11, faster of the two laps for Bill Vint, the 280CX. All right, we're going to go up to the V8 division next. Coming up next, V8 Division, 79 Chevy Camaro, Dave McGonigal. Dave McGonigal, 79 Chevy Camaro. Sounds like sufficient horsepower under the hood, but how can it turn left? 22.71 on the first lap. For Dave McGonigal. Black Chevy Camaro, 22.58, faster of the two laps. Up next, Yannick Sire in a 1968 Chevy Chevelle. Yannick Sire, S-I-R-E is the spelling of the last name. Whoa, he's got some horsepower under the hood of this one, but whoa, backwards he goes. That's supposed to put on the brake. Just stay off the brake. That's what you got to do, get it around the corner. Some horsepower under the hood of this one. It sounds great. That's it. That's it. No brakes. Get it around the corner. I tell you, this guy is moving. At 20.72. No brakes. No throttle. There you go. Yeah. Nice job. Nice job. Way to go, Yannick. Got a little bit of a push right there coming off of turn four. At 20.53. Faster second lap. Tell ya, got that booger around the racetrack. That's a rust-colored Chevy Chevelle. I'd like to know what's under the hood. I'm guessing it's a rat motor under the hood, but big block, anybody think so, maybe? What do we got next? This is a 1967 Chevy Camaro. Dave Virgini. V-E-R-G-I-N-I. Dave Virgini. 67 Camaro. Stay off the brakes, Dave. A little bit of throttle right there would have saved you. Down the back straight. hard to get the car around the corner with those little tires on the front. Set up for drag racing. A 25.37. First lap for Dave Virginie. He'll do a little better on the second lap. And he does a 22.72. Dave Virginie, nice job in the 67 Camaro.
Blankenship jumps off in turn two, out into a three-car lead.
pretty good contact with the turn three wall over there. And the starter going red.
71's out.
Don't go out there. Joey Bolio on the outside of three cars going into turn three. And made a pretty good contact with the turn three wall out there. Joey currently seventh place in the point standings on the 93 season. Finishes 20 out of 24 starts. He was in the top 10 and still finished second place. 1992 he was second again with 20 top 5 finishes, including 7 main event wins. 22 of 26 starts in the top 10, but finished second in the point standings, trying to nail down a championship here in 1993. As the 74 car, Scott Dinger. And the horse history goes back to 1988. For my history, he was fourth in the Pro Stock Championships. He sat out. Let's give away Coleman Ice Chest, courtesy of JB Wholesale. A beautiful Coleman Ice Chest. This is also a yellow ticket. 002-368. And as Joey comes around in the ambulance, let him hear you. Take him over and check him out at Henry Mayo.
Thank you.
off the racetrack. He's out there spun backwards underneath the scoreboard. What can I say? Can't see him. And there's the green flag back in the racing. Garrett Cromside in 26, Greg Benner. Four fastest street stockers, entry-level racing division here at Saga Speedway. Looking for the green. Troy Terry on the outside, gets a little bit loose. Conrad, Terry, and Cromside throw a blanket over the three of them. Todd Conrad trying to hang on the lead from Garrett Cromside in second, Terry third, and Greg Benner fourth. To the outside in turn one and two and just motors on around the 76 car. Cromside now in front. On the white flag lap. Garrett Cromside has won 8 trophy dashes so far this year and about to take checkered flag number 9 on the trophy dash scene. Cromside the winner. Conrad finishes second. Greg Benner, the 26 car, third. And number 38, Troy Terry, finishes in fourth. A BMW, a Datsun, a Pinto, and a Renault. What a group for our trophy hats. That's our mini shots tonight. The green flag is out. We're racing. The 99 car, a Beamer, an old 2002. The 03 car, a Datsun 43, a Pinto, and the 07, a Renault, rear engine Renault. Some of us used to call them Renaults. Amy Pfeiffer, Brad Billy, Damon Duckett. Trying to get underneath off of turn two. Brad Billing trying to take the lead. There he comes, taking the white flag. Brad Billing's in front. Pfeiffer second. Liberopoulos now third. The winner, Jamie Pfeiffer, finishes second. Jerry Liberopoulos gets third, and David Duckett finishes fourth. Here we go. It's green. Carvasco
Up next is the Pro Four Modified Dash winner, number 10, in the Indy Auto year. It's about to get
away. Up next, make some noise. Winning his second dash for 1993. Nice job. The 76 car top Conrad. Congratulations, Doc.
Thank you.
Good. I'm not supposed to stand so close. My girlfriend's over here.
Right? And making it two in a row. Two broken dashes on both the old track and the new track. Their current 20-year NASCAR road guys. Prize moving in storage to now. Scott Dinger. Congratulations. Yeah.
Been there, done that, right?
And how about a big song as people welcome for our favorite duo, Jan and Joe Benson. Come on up here. Thompson and Hopkins.
baby.
The way they're going to put it in the books, the first four, 48, Sean Monroe, the winner. 22, Brian Kelly in second. 72, Garrett Kromside finishes in third. And 49, Ed Horst finishes in fourth. The 17 car, a backward spin into the infield, almost all the way off the track, but not quite, and everybody coming to a stop. Taking another checker down the main street.
somebody told him to turn the mirror up. Don't watch the mirror. Just drive. Coming up next, the main event for street stocks. The top 20 qualifiers in the street stock division automatically get a starting position in the feature race. The B main for those cars who did not qualify in the top 20 will take the first four cars out of the B main and transfer into the feature race for the NASCAR Street Stock Division. A 10-lap B main event for NASCAR Street Stock.
High B Stock
race. Berkowitz and Severance in the front row. Gilmore. West and Estes. Number two, Bob Severance in second. Sean Estes in the 10th car has moved all the way into third already. And Mike Gilmore is in four. And Estes, off the turn two on the outside. And a second.
Coming up in a few minutes. Beautiful car.
line. Todd Conrad, check that. Garrett Cromsey. Cromsey takes the win. Todd Conrad gets the second place finish. Train on the next lap. Second place going to 58, Jeff McCall. Third place, the 8 car, Bob Pluck. And fourth, number 22, Robert Hines. That's the way they're going to put it in the books, wire to wire. No yellows all the way through, a 20-lap main event for NASCAR Mini Stocks. Jeff Van and Karmasek on the front row, pairing them up. Lights out, pace car in the infield. We got one more lap before we look for green. Figure eight main events and the Pro 4 modified main event. Lots of racing. 25 lap pro stock feature on the oval track looking for green. Green. head back to the pit to change the left rear. Expecting the green, but we have, we're still yellow, the 23 car. Some reason, stop over in turn number two. We're here during the month of August. And we're getting set to go back to green flag racing, and we are. There's the green once again. Flat on the right front, and Bill Fife, the 36 car, not able to drive. One more time, look for green. car. Contact, and around goes the 72 car. Bringing out the red flag on lap number 21. Turn number one grandstand, the pit grandstand, there's somebody that we need to make a special request of. I have seated next to me in the press box the winner of the NASCAR Main Stock Main Event, Jerry Mielke. And Jerry Mielke says, Jeannie Friedrich, will you marry me? Jenny? Jerry Mielke wants to marry you. He's waiting for your answer. Go get her answer, Jerry. Congratulations on your win tonight. Nice going. Man, Joe Vincent on the inside. Greg Simon's on the outside. Unless the 42 gets back it out of there, put it in reverse and back away. It'll take a minute or two to separate the two of them while they're doing that. I'm going to tell you what else. Side in front, stuck in turn number four over there. That becomes turn four on the figure eight track. And that brought out the red flag. Bauer and Berkowitz. Yeah. Is it time? You picked a fine time to leave me loose wheels. And our ever-ready track crew over to seize the moving wheel. And we're back to green. Comes out, wouldn't you know it, the car is able to drive away. That's always the way it happens. First six car. Off the end, and he's back on the way. is the yellow, the 72 of Conway. Battery moves, and back to the pit he goes, the 33 car, Karbacek. He also goes back to the pit. 74, Scott Dinger. Now the leader, 49 Ed Horst is in second. Brian Kelly, the 22 car, being shown in third place. I'm not sure he didn't get hooked up with somebody over there. Okay, he's back underway. Or is he going back to the pit? Yes, he's headed for the pit. The 22 car will not be in the third when we get a restart. Stock division. Put our five laps remaining in the books for Pro Stock Figure 8 Main. Next time around, the starter says, watch for green. Scott Dinger, Ed Horst, Sean Monroe, and Dave Blankenship. That's your first four cars. get the start again, get a green flag, we'll get a white and a green. One lap remaining. Finishes in fourth place. Win 1-4 to 74, Scott Dinger.